Welcome to the ND Grants training video on submitting an amendment for an award. In this video, you will learn the process of how to create and submit an amendment through the non-disaster grant system. A grantee can submit an amendment request to make a change to an award. It is important to note that using the Internet Explorer browser will yield the best results for working in ND Grants. As a reminder, several quick reference guides are available at FEMA.gov that provide step-by-step instructions for completing all tasks in ND Grants. We'll begin by explaining the various types of changes that a grantee can request as seen on the table. Please note that an amendment to change the primary and secondary contact assigned to an award will not require a FEMA internal review. However, all other amendment request types will require an internal review by FEMA. The types of amendment requests that will require a FEMA internal review are changes to the assigned authorized official or the signatory authority, changes to the period of performance dates for the award, changes to the budget total or changes to the scope of work, and lastly, changes to have a term and condition removed from the award. A few important details to remember when submitting an amendment. Please discuss your requested changes with your FEMA program manager before you submit the amendment. This will help ensure you have properly justified the proposed changes correctly before you submit. Also, if the current assigned authorized official has left the organization, another user with the organization that has the authorized official role may submit an authorized official amendment. Please note, in this case, that must be the only change requested in the amendment. No other changes can be requested in the amendment, as you will not be able to submit because you are not the current authorized official. Now that we have introduced different types of amendments that can be submitted and distinguished a few key details to note before submitting, let's take a quick look at the prerequisites for submitting an amendment. The most important thing needed to submit an amendment is that you must currently have the authorized official role assigned to you for your organization. In addition, you cannot submit an amendment if there is another amendment currently pending review or deobligations for the award. Lastly, amendment requests to change the period of performance cannot be submitted if a performance report is pending review. You now understand the various types of amendments and understand the prerequisites for submitting them. Now let's get started in creating an amendment. Once you are logged into the ND Grants system, click the Grants dropdown from the menu bar at the top of the ND Grants homepage. From the dropdown, click the Manage Amendments link. This action will take you to the Amendment Administration page. You should now be at the Amendment Administration page. From this page, you will see all previously submitted, approved, withdrawn, and denied amendments. At the top right of this page, click the blue Create Amendment button. This action will bring up the Select Grant dropdown. From the Select Grant dropdown, type in or select your grant number that you want to submit an amendment for. Once you have the grant number typed in or selected, click the blue Create Amendment button. This action will take you to the Amendment Creation page. Please note that if there is currently an amendment in progress for the award, a message will appear indicating that a new amendment cannot be created until the previous one has been processed. You should now be at the Create Amendment Request page. You will notice the toolbox on the left-hand side. These are the links that will take you to the various sections of the page. Under that, you should see the Cancel, Save, and the blue Submit button. If the blue Submit button is not shown for you, please go back and check to see that you have the authorized official role for your organization. The first step for your amendment is to fill out the Amendment Request Narrative text box. This is where you will justify your amendment request. This text box must be filled out in order for you to be able to submit the amendment. The next section on the page is the Contact section, where you can reassign the roles for the award to users within your organization. At the top, you will see the Search for Contact search bar. This is where you will search for users within your organization that you want to add to this award. Once you have selected the name, Click the plus icon to the right of the bar to add the name to the contact listing. Please note, when changing the authorized official, if you need to add a new contact to the listing, you must select the version of the user that has their user ID associated to the contact. This will allow the system to properly identify what user for your organization is a new authorized official. In this section, you will also see the red trash can icons under the action column. If you need to remove a user from the listing, you can do so by clicking that icon. Next on the page is a period of performance section. This is where you can request to change the period of performance start and or end dates for the award. To do so, you must click the calendar icon and select the new dates. Following the period of performance section is a budget section of the amendment page. Here's where you can adjust the funding amounts to the various budget categories. Please contact your FEMA program manager before making adjustments to the budget section. The final section of this page is a terms and conditions section where you can request to have terms and conditions removed from your award. To do this, you must click the Remove button located under the Action column. To undo this step, click the Cancel button under the Action column. Once you have made all the change requests in your amendment, you are now ready to submit. To submit the amendment, click the blue Submit button found on the left-hand side of the screen under the Toolbox menu. If the blue Submit button is missing, please review all changes made to the amendment to ensure that you have made them correctly. You may also refer back to Step 7 of this video for more assistance. This concludes the video. For additional assistance using the ENDI grant system, please contact the ENDI grant service desk at 1-800-865-4076 or endigrants@fema.dhs.gov. For programmatic or grant management questions, please contact your program analyst or grant specialist. Thank you.